I don't want to say like, okay, do you think that they kind of tried to smooth over what was happening to us with all the R&B music? It's like, dang, now you got me thinking, like, because there was really a lot going on at that time. So
No,
were
I think
they
they tried to move over with the hype of the gangster rap.
okay?
Because
That makes
the
sense.
gangster rap at first wasn't just like I'ma kill son. Like it wasn't just on that type of time. It was just people saying what most people were afraid to.
Right.
Same thing like Bloods and Crips. It started out as
Yeah.
community of people that was, you know, had a little rough
Exactly.
background on them that was willing to, you know, get out there and step out there on some man like type of vibe, but it turned into what it is now.
Yeah, it turned into what we all expected. I mean, not us, but what they expected, because they knew how to break that up. It seemed like it was like a
They
real bit of,
always do. They hit us with the same tricks every single time.
right,
And
exactly.
as like every time we come up with a
Every
strong,
single time.
they just flip it right back up on us and use it against us. Like it's the same trick, like same rabbit, same hat.
Well, I
That's
wouldn't.
like, that's why it's cool. I think that's why they labeled it gangster rap,
Of course.
to do that. Yeah, because the gangster is that you got people standing up to the system or to the enemy, and then they turned it into like, nah, this is about gangs and drugs. Yeah, all right, it makes sense.
But they also control the platform, they control the system that you need.
Silence is the key, you know what I'm saying? When it comes down to it, when you're playing chess, you don't tell somebody in two moves, I'm gonna move my bishop. I also wanted to say, explaining the experience I had with listening to the song, Brenda Had a Baby, that shows me that you should be careful the words you use and the energy that you put in your music. You know what I'm saying? The way that energy hit me when I was 7 years old, I remember that. So I always knew lyrically to watch the energy that I express as well, because this energy is really hitting, it hits you. Like if you bump that, you're gonna feel that. So I think that now that that's understood, the music that we make, I'm saying this for anybody listening to as well, just to start to learn to embrace making better music, positive, more positive music, because the music that we making, little kids is getting access to it. Anybody can get on YouTube and listen to one of my songs right now. Anybody can get on YouTube and listen to Royalty right now, or Ronnie Brown's, or Squeaky, or they can listen to all of us at once. So why put some music out there that the second they hear it is gonna hit them with a heavy load of something they don't need in their life?
That's real. It's way too easy to get to the music nowadays. Like I remember, like certain CD stores when I was younger, they wouldn't let me buy certain stuff. I remember I tried to get a, I think I was coming back from like Florida or something, and they had a FYE in the airport. And I tried to buy a Tony Ayo album. They wouldn't let me get that drink by myself.
Yeah, I remember. Yeah, it used to be like that. That's true. You couldn't even buy certain video games without,
Word.
like, I was combined at a certain age. Wow, we were really like fake protected, like low key back
Yeah,
then.
that's when they cared about parental, you know, consent and all of that. It
That
parental
was the big deal. That was the big deal. Like, yo, this is gangster rap. You know what I mean? They had real cases. Uncle Luke and Ice-T, they had real cases. They the reason Too Short. They the reasons that parental advisory sticker's on there.
Wow.
That's crazy.
Nah, that's a fact. That's that as a fact.
All right, so I mean, I think this was, you know, so far, this right here is definitely a great, it's great insight, you know what I'm saying? It's great steps towards making things better and getting a better sound out there, as well as your music. You know, your music is setting a certain tone as well. It's setting a certain tone, and I'm gonna tell you right now, this time period, this time is the time where your music is about to start getting more appreciated. This time is the time where that sound is about to start getting more appreciated. It's gonna take a little bit more time, but it's coming back around. Everything that happens before happens again, and that's music is one of them. Music is just the background sound of our lives, right? Well, the background sound frequencies from before is gonna start to come back. So
I try to keep it timeless. Like I try to remove the time from it. You know what I mean? Like for me, it's like I really believe in, you know, being yourself. That's the key. As long as I'm being myself and when I create music, I create it just off the feeling. You know what I mean? As long as I can execute the feeling that I'm trying to execute, it's going to do exactly what it's supposed to do. You know what I mean? I don't care about the super popularity. You know what I mean? Like, it's just about, like, is this a great song? And the people that, you know, it reaches, and when people hear it, you know what I mean, they might not get it right away, and that's cool. But eventually they will. Like, anybody that it hits, it hits hard. You know what I mean? It's not just like, oh, this is a cool song. It's like, nah, like, I feel this. And that's not accidental. Like, I sit and I study timeless music on purpose. I study timeless performances, like anything that is like, why are we still listening to this in this day and age? I study it. How is it written? Why? What words is being used? You know what I mean? I study all the aspects of it.
That's dope.
So when somebody hears this, and somebody hears your music, and they realize, yo, this song is still dope 4 years later, they're gonna want to. Yeah. What I'm saying is, that's about to come to life. Like, making music to make timeless music. That was a thing at one point. That's not the thing right now. To make music for it to last,
you gotta want timeless rewards. You know what I mean? If you just want a quick reward, like, I don't care about being cool. You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't want to be the cool guy. That's whatever. That does nothing for me. That's because you're gonna be uncool one day. Everything gets played out.
Staying solid, standing tall, is cool.
Yeah, that's cool. But that's timeless. You know, those people that are solid are the people you have in your life for years.
That's cool though. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, and the people that
don't last the test of time, they were bozos. Absolutely. They were never cool, or either that, exactly. Or they were just never for you.
Exactly.
And that shows in your artistry as well. Definitely.
Thank you.
Welcome.
Yeah, for sure. We definitely gonna you know, the tune is gonna be playing, and they gonna get, you know, what's going on for sure. So we here now, you know what I'm saying? We down to the last question. Is there any side comments, any side suggestions, any, you know, thoughts that was inspired during this conversation anybody want to share?
How do you guys think the over-sexualization in the music, like, affected our generation?
That's a good question, because that is kind of...
Like, do you guys feel like basically what we went through as a result of what the younger generation is displaying now?
Yeah,
I feel like the over sexualization is breaking up families, because since we out here expressing, using all our sexual energy with anybody, having random sex, it's now we're not taking the time to actually find somebody that's compatible with us.
Yeah, and there's no respect.
That's not even being taught.
Yeah, if you especially if you married and you doing things on the gram that is not marriage like, but y'all have an agreement, and it's like, dag, is that what you show your children, that it's okay to do such and such when you have a whole husband or you have a whole wife? Like, that the whole respect thing for overall the quote unquote black family, that whole agenda they just destroyed by doing that, over sexualizing the singers, the artists, and they knew it would destroy this generation today.
I mean, it's more than just the music though. Like, everything is sexualized. I can't even go on Instagram without half naked women popped up out of nowhere. Like, you know what I mean? I don't gotta search it enough. It's there.
Yeah. Where did that start though? That started in videos.
Like I said earlier, they hit you with the same tactics. You know what I mean? Like, they ain't just start destroying families. They hit you with the same tactics each time.
Saying the question that he was saying was like, how do you think it affects the generation today? I think that's how it affects the generation today. It's been like, what?
Yeah, I agree.
It's been 300 years. Yeah, I started it off with the, you know what I'm saying? The breaking up with the man from the woman and the child. You did that. And then you put us on the runway in your circus act. So we're wearing, you stole our labels, our clothing line, you stole our patterns, and now you made it designer labels, and you had us walking around like circus acts in the clothing. And to now, you made us your singers, your rappers, your comedians, your tap dancers. And then now it's like, dag, the children is looking, they're watching. They have always been watching, and they're confused. and you're not teaching it in your indoctrinated schools. You're not showing it in your hospitals. You're killing us while we're giving birth. You're stealing out. You're just doing everything to keep y'all legacy alive. Y'all use us. We make y'all rich because of our ignorance. You made us ignorant, so now you're rich off our ignorance. You make money off of us. Now when we want to fight back and keep our masters, we want our rights, we want our land, we want our 400 acres and a mule plus more, we want everything back. Now it's a problem because y'all know y'all rich because of us. Like, let's keep that a whole fact right now. So
it's like, always been a problem. So I agree.
Down to the sports. It's like, come on. Y'all know how it started. So it's like, now y'all can't even muster up the strength to create your own, you know what I'm saying, your own sports thing. Like, you know, it's crazy.
Well, I want to say one more thing. Is it the influence or is it the surface at this point? Because if you see bad fruit, are you going to keep eating it? Or are you going to be like, yo, I ain't even going to front. This fruit done rotten 3 of our generations. You know what? Let me change up the fruit. Like, after a while, it's just like, all right, it's awful now.
But you got to understand that it's always a constant attack. You know what I mean? You could change, you know what I'm saying? They always told, we grew up, you know what I mean? With, you know, these messages, you know what I'm saying? These positive messages that was, you know, supposedly for a change. But it's like, how much change does it really have when they're constantly attacking us? You know what I mean? We on defense more than we actually get to be on offense. You know what I'm saying?
I'm going to say this hands down. The Black Panthers is the best thing that's ever happened to the Black and Brown community. The Black Wall Street has been the best thing, hands down, to happen to the Black and Brown community. Let's take it back to that. Like, let's get it together as a people now. Come on, wake up. Everybody, just wake up. Come, because it's getting annoying now. It's getting real frustrating for a lot of us that really want to get it together and just, like, unify and not be in fear. Like, we really fear God. We don't fear none of y'all, nobody. We really, really, really wish that our artists, our community, our politicians, like, get it together. Because y'all looking stupid and y'all not going nowhere but to that lake of fire. Like, if that's what y'all want, then cool. But give us respect. Like, respect that we don't want that. Respect that we don't want to go where y'all going. Respect that we want to make music that's going to uplift our community and our children. Like, you got to respect that line. We don't overstep and cross y'all line. Like, we just simply, you know what I'm saying, just do our own thing. We want to stay us. We want to stay human. We want to stay true. Like, just let us be us.
I do think that there are constant attacks, and I'm not saying this in a way where it's just like, oh yeah, I'm just throwing it off. Like, you know, it's easy, just decide to change it and you change it. Like, nah. But what I'm saying is that at this point, a lot of us sit here and put ourselves, we engage in willful destruction, you know, for ourselves amongst each other on a regular day basis. And we're going to have to take some type of accountability for that. Because at the end of the day, yeah, the gun may be there, the drug may be there, the access may be there, the person that you was mad at may be there, the people that you disagree with may be there, the things that you hate may be around, but you still have to sit there and actually decide to be like, okay, I'm about to do this.
Mm-hmm. But see, it's an uphill battle for us because, you know, it's that, but it's also like, you got to, before you can even convince him, like, yo, you got to do this, you got to convince him to unlearn what he already know. This is, we suffering effects from slavery times, Willie Lynch theory. They said it in the letter, like, you know what I'm saying? If this is done correctly, you're going to have control for thousands of years to come. You set up a whole system. You put in young against old, men against women. Now right. What's going to happen to the next generation seeing that? They not going to be the same people. And then it's like, you know, slavery specifically is like, we got to acknowledge that was the whole Southern half. That's how they was getting money. Now they switched the law on them. And then, you know, now they cut your money off. You think they're going to be, they think it's just going to roll over? You know what I mean? Nah. Right, now you can't drink at this water fountain. Now you can't, you know, get this job. Now you can't, we might let you vote. You know what I'm saying? Like, everything's like an uphill battle.
People don't even know their history for real. Like, you know, the South with all was Democrats. They wanted to keep their slaves. Mm-hmm. The Republicans was like, nah, we not with that. You go up North, everybody Republican, you're not with that. So people don't, they try to just start where it was the Civil War. Like, they, y'all not even trying to take it back to when we were kings and queens, right, Design? They not trying to take it back to where, you know, Moors were in charge. We were rulers. They not even trying to take it to, they ain't trying to let you go there. Because if you go there, that's when it's a problem. You'll find out the truth.
1492 is the mark. I want to make it clear for the message. 1492 is the mark. If you search before 1492, you're going to find out you ain't black.
And then you'll understand, like, okay, you're in a corporation. You'll understand, like, all right, dag, my identity has been completely frauded out. Like, money is you will never be broke once you realize and do your research and study. Like, all right, for real, this money is fake. Stop with the games. We play Monopoly. Y'all really trying to play off our ignorance because you only getting rich off of our taxes, off of tax and everything. We fought for y'all. We fought in war. Shout out to everybody that's in the military or that fought for this country and unknowingly did think they were fighting for this country, for their people, for their family. But honestly, shout out to all of everybody. Shout out to Tyree, developer, our administrative room in the building. And just knowing, like, my grandfather was a veteran, like, and he was in the music as well. It's like, he fought against people, like, he didn't want to fight. Y'all started wars with everyone for no reason. And even if you didn't start it, you was trying to mind your business at first. What happened? Oh, this person is funding y'all war, y'all weapons and all kind of stuff. And it's like, y'all really allow whatever y'all did with the money. Y'all took away our gold. Y'all took away our original money. Whatever kind of BS y'all pulled over after 1933, y'all really allowed that to affect the whole human race. Wars, war, everything was about creating a war to gain more power over this land, over, and keep spreading and owning more land, more countries, more power. Everything is power and greed at this point, and this is where we at now. Y'all completely bamboozled our people into thinking it's okay to rap about death, rap about killing each other, rap about drugs, sex, money, cars, clothes,
disrespecting women too.
Disrespecting women. You got the women out here blaspheming everything that exists about them. You got them uproaring and praising men that wants to be women. This is getting out of hand now. It's really getting out of hand now. It's disrespectful because I'm a woman. First of all, you're not going to ask me what's the definition of a woman. I am a whole woman. I give birth. Okay, so you're not going to sit here and play games with us like we don't know what a woman is. That's because y'all don't believe in God. Y'all don't read the Bible. Y'all don't read anything that was left here from your ancestors, because even your ancestors would tell you, yo, they gave you a Bible, they gave you this, they gave you religion. Everything is man-made. Y'all follow behind false prophets. Y'all don't want to unlearn anything because the truth hurts. The truth hurts. We get it. But find that truth and just from there, create your own reality from there. Just realize that, you know what I'm saying? You can change your reality. When you figure this matrix out and you break that shit and you decode it, yo, teach it to the next person. Because real people, real human beings, real positive human beings will want you to do that. We're not even talking about race right now. These people who are in power for the right reasons, they want you to teach your own people the truth.
Yeah, that's a fact. Big facts on everything.
Yeah. Yeah, man, that's just what we going through. Like, we as a whole, we going through many different things, so it's a lot to take in. All right, so we here down to this last question right here. What's something that you would change about hip-hop if you had the influence to do so from any position of power you would choose, like A&R, or, you know, if you were a high-level DJ, or if you were a label owner, or something of that sort, like if you had that type of power?
I'm trying to decipher, is that even powerful? You know what I mean? But if I had, like, you know what I mean, like my own platform of some sort, like kind of like how like Revolt is, or it's still a small thing, but it's like at least you could, things being on television hit a lot of homes at the same time. So you could kind of control and use your influence to, you know, draw attention that way. And then you got the power to paint whatever positive light or just inform people. If I had the platform that, you know what I mean, I could really make it, use the influence to inform people, in a way where it's like they'd be curious about it. We're not just being like preachy. Like that'd be the best thing.
Yeah, like something creative.
Yeah, like something that they'd be naturally just curious about, something to keep their interest, but you still giving out some game. Cause it's your responsibility to do that. You gotta. That's another thing. Like, you know, we hold it in. We don't. You done figured it out, so you hype that you figured it out. You don't want nobody else to go because you know how hard it was for you to figure it out. You know what I mean? So you're not as easy to pass it on. But we got to get more comfortable passing on the game. Like, all right, somebody did the hard work. All right, you know, let's make it easy for you. Because we make it hard. We leave everybody to start all over again from the bottom.
Right. I truly believe that we make it hard for one another, especially, quote, unquote, black people, Afro-American, all these damn anonymous, whatever you want to call us. Okay? Mm-hmm. We make it so hard for one another, down to the housing. Once you get in a position and you so-called call yourself black and you make it hard for the next black, brown person, honestly, you're trash. You're a hater and you will always be trash. That's just my opinion. But in my head, it's the truth because you are purposely making sure that that next person does not level up because you're so afraid that that person is going to be a level up than you. And mm-hmm. it's going to happen regardless. You are not in control. You are not anybody's God. You are not in control. You may have a little power here and there, but listen, you're not helping the next person level up. You're not even passing the mic or the torch or the crown to the next person, and you stopping people's bags and their money. Like, honestly, you're a part of the problem. You know what I'm saying? Everybody can get second chances and all that stuff, but don't expect it from us. You gotta ask God for that, because once you mess up with us, you already know. It's like, all right, cool, you block, you know, you're a dub. You're gonna get bad mouth because how you treat people. People don't want that. Especially like we going through a time where women is being the most disrespected ever, like ever mm-hmm. in history. Disrespected, like, and it's a horrible genocide going on the men. Y'all are purposely trying to make all men feminine. We may not be able to do such and such on the radar. You know, they watch you at certain levels or whatever. Certain levels, certain amount of money you make, whatever. But when are we going to just take our power back and get into create positions to change the narrative? Because like you said TV, right? If you had a position, you would do TV to reach out to the people and change the narrative for artists. Cool. We can start that. We could do that. But sometimes we can't talk about everything and put it out there like that. You can't be telling, like Deson said, you can't be telling everybody all your moves. If you're going to do something, sometimes we're going to have to do it like Harriet Tubman style. The devil roaming to and fro, and they looking for any kind of way to trap you. Death traps.
Mm-hmm.
So you label yourself as Afro-American, white, Indian, Native American. You're already a death trap. You're in a death trap. You don't know how to manipulate your straw man. You don't know how to honor your debts with the fake money. You don't know how to do none of that. You're in a death trap. You signing your life away for 50 years and you don't leave your kids nothing because your own people all trying to get famous and taking over your life. You're in a death trap.
For real, though.
I'm sorry.
When you gotta... I'm gonna... Nah, it's all good.
Gems in the building.
Holla at me.
You feel me? Yes, sir.
Yeah, man. That's you know, we wrapping it up here. But, you know, it's, sometimes it get real. You know what I'm saying? I think you had to get a couple of things off your chest, so.
Very necessary.
Right, yeah. Right.
You know, we here. This is Creative Collection. I'm going to give y'all both opportunity. Ronnie and Royalty, do y'all have anything, you know, to say before we wrap it up completely and shout these sponsors out?
Thank y'all for doing this with me. This was pretty cool. We definitely touched on a lot of dope topics. Everybody listening, y'all can check out the album. It's called Life in the Color Brown. We got more music on the way. Y'all can follow me on the IG. I'm Ronnie Brown. And yeah, thank y'all for like having me.
Sure, man.
No doubt.
For sure.
This is Ronnie Brown. I miss the 90s. We ain't gotta put no act on. They be like rap rons and twang gon' roll up to the pack gone.
can tell you ass, you ain't even gotta act, son, and we not. But if it's nice, I'll slap one from here to Queens. We was back in Queens, where it happened, Queens, where the action, Queens. It feel good, don't it? It feel good, don't it? From here to Queens, we was back in Queens, where it happened, Queens, where the action, Queens. It feel good, don't it? It feel good, don't it? Brought back the flavor like a new stick of gum. Bit off the foundation back from when we were young. Don't wait for it, it already begun. We cooking, and only when it's brown is it done. I kick this shit like Beckham when I wreck 'em. Going against this is a gamble, don't bet 'em. They get away with it when you let 'em. Shit can get deep like the D when she spread 'em. I sway through the universe like swaying the universe. And since I don't have the answers, I murder you in the verse. These days it pays to have nothing to say. Made to be seen and not heard even today. Inhale, exhale, blow the rest out. Weather locked and never been, they even fresh out. It's finally summertime, they got their summer dress out. No bra under that top, they got their summer dress out. From here to Queens, we was back in Queens, where it happened, Queens, where the action, Queens. It feel good, don't it?